Sometimes when you're using the if function, you need to check for multiple criteria. In other words, the logical test has to be expanded. That's the first portion, the first argument in an if function. This organization has decided to give bonuses to people who have a job rating of 4 or 5. However, they must be full-time. So two conditions must be met. We're about to use the and function along with the if function. A companion function is called or, and to a lesser extent, a function called not could also be used. We'll see examples of all three. Column I doesn't really have to be wider, but let's make it wider so we can see the function clearly here. Equal if. We need to check for two conditions. We use the word and. Sometimes we use and with 3 or 4 or 5. We can actually use it up to 127 conditions. And in no particular order, we're saying the job rating, that's in cell J2 here, needs to be greater than 3, comma. And the status, it's in cell F2, must be equal to full-time. This is a text entry, so we need to embed this within a double quotes. So a double quote, full-time. Full-time has a space in it, must be in the example here. The upper lowercase, oddly enough, isn't critical, but why not make it look the same as the entries here? Right parenthesis. There are four possibilities. The first entry here can be true, and the second one can be true, but one could be true and false, or false true, or false false. So four possibilities here. Only when both are true is the answer going to be 3,000. So we put in a comma, 3,000. Both need to be true for 3,000 to be the answer. When either one of those is not true, comma, the answer is perhaps 0, or we could put in a blank with double quote, double quote. Closing right parenthesis here, I'll press Control Enter, copy this down the column. And as you can clearly see, as we expose the formula again, only when the job rating is good and the status is full-time is there a bonus here. Now, if we were to use the word or, and we could in this case, I think you know immediately what's going to happen. If we use or, we're saying if either condition is true, it's going to be a more popular decision, that's for sure. But if either condition is true, so out of the four possibilities here, only when we see false, false will there be no bonus. So I'll just press Control Enter here to change all of these, and we see what's happening there. If you know your data well, as we've been saying in some of these examples here, these fall into place a bit more readily than you might think. But let's change this in a different way. This gets a little more complex, or can be at times, if the need arises. The company changes its mind again and says the following. We've decided that if you've got a good job rating, we don't care what your status is, we will give you the bonus. So let's look at this or function in a different way. Either this is true, or sometimes what you'll see is an and inside of an or in some cases, an or inside of an and. What are we saying here? What are we about to say? If your job rating is not good enough, we'll still give you the bonus if your status is full-time, comma, and your years of service, that's in cell E3 here, is greater than 9. Another right parenthesis required. Notice how the parentheses are color-coded. For every left, there must be a right, and the colors stay in sync there. We're about to change this. I'll press Control Enter here and make that column wider, and make this even better. I'll zoom in a bit, holding down the Control key and the mouse wheel, and then moving to the right so we can see all the relevant cells. What are we saying now? You will get the bonus automatically if your job rating is 4 or 5, and we see that happening in a number of cases. But if you don't have a job rating of 4 or 5, you can still get the bonus because this is the second part of the or structure. If this is true, you still get the bonus. So some people might be full-time and have 9 years. They're going to get the bonus regardless of possibly bad job rating. So that's happening too. And we can see this in row 8, for example, looking at the data right here. Off to the right, job rating of 1. Off to the left, full-time, 13 years. So in a variety of different ways, you can use or and. And again, it's not necessarily aimed toward more complexity, but to be able to cover those cases that are needed. Now, the word not can also be used. I tend to shy away from it. It tends to be harder to read. But what if somehow or other this company changes its mind again and says, we don't give bonuses to hourly people? And we want to say, to make it a real simple example, what if we say, if your status is not hourly, you will get the bonus? Put in the word not right here, and in here, we'll simply focus on the idea that status is equal to hourly. But we put the word not in front of it, and we could do this in other ways too, using different symbols there. By the way, that upper or lower case, again, not critical, but it looks better this way. Could have used the uppercase there. So this is another way to use it. And again, a lot of people find that awkward. Nevertheless, that will work here. Double click. Who gets the bonus? Everybody except someone who's hourly. So every time we see a blank here in column I, it's because that person is hourly. So that's a different construction as well. So at different times, be alert not only to the idea of these, but the fact that you sometimes need to use these. And again, not is a little bit unusual, but the other two, and or, widely used when we need to test for multiple conditions within an if function.